Welcome back, students, to my new lecture on the topic epidermal derivatives like claws, nails, and hoofs. Claws, nails, and hoofs are the modification of stratum corneum. They are the hardy structure at the distal end of the digits. And the stratum lucidum of the epidermis is best developed at the base of the teeth structure. True claw are present only in reptiles, birds, and mammals. The claw then evolve into nails in primates and into hoofs in ungulates. Therefore, claws, nails, and hoofs all have the same basic structure, all contain unguis and subunguis. This is the unguis and this is a subunguis. It is a unguis and it is a subunguis. So therefore, claw, nail, and hoofs all are contain same basic structure, but they're different on the anatomical arrangement. Claw is composed of two carpels, horny dorsal plate, that is the unguis, and softer ventral part, that is the subunguis or solihon. The two plates, unguis and subunguis, that wrap partially around the terminal phalanx, which is usually pointed. The unguis is better developed here. In the typical reptilian claw, the unguis is cupped both longitudinally and transversely, enclosing the subunguis between its lower edges. Whereas in case of the birds, the claws are usually present in the feet of the birds. But one or two subclaws may also occur at the end of the digits of the wings of ostriches and geese, and some swifts also. Young Hadrian Opisthokomas, they bear claws on the first two digits of the wings. The claws disappear when the Hadrian gets older. Woodpecker have very sharp narrow claws with which they anchor themselves firmly into tree bark during drilling. In mammal, the subunguis is reduced and continuous with the torus or pad at the end of the digit. Members of the cat family, the claw are retractile in nature. When not used, they are withdrawn into the sheath and thus protected. In lemur, nails are present on certain digits of the hind feet and claws are present rest on the others. Nails are found only in primates. Nails are placed of highly compact epithelial cell on the surface of the finger and toes. Thus, they are product of keratinizing system of the skin. The nail matrix formed new nails at the nail base by pushing the existing nail forward to replace the broken nail at the free edge. The unguis of the nail is broad. This is unguis of the nail, that is a broad and flattened. The subunguis, that is to be reduced to a small remnant which lies under the tip of the nail. The dermis of the nail bed underlying the unguis is highly vascular, and that is evident from the pinkish color of the nail. Here are different types of the nails, that is a young lady nail, that is the colors for their attractions. This is a father and child recognitions, and this is also mother to infant recognitions, and this is another primates, different type of the nails are present here. Now the hoofs. The hoofs are the special structure. They are restricted mainly to some specialized groups of the mammals, particularly in ungulates. It is much harder. It is much harder and thicker structure than claw and nail. And it is specially built to bear the body weight of the animals. This is a hoop of eventoid ungulate, and this is a hoop of octoid ungulate. Unguis is large. Unguis is large. This is unguis is large. And the animal actually walk over it. The unguis curves all the way around the end of the digits and encloses the subunguis. The torus or the fleshy plates just lies behind the hoops, and that is called the frog or cuneus. Frog is composed of hard keratin and unguis wire very slowly. Work horses are customarily sought to prevent the unguis from wearing away too rapidly. Metal shoe are nailed to this portion of the hoop. Since the hoop grows continuously, the shoes must be removed occasionally. The unguis is then pared down and the shoe nailed on again. These are the reference books. Thank you.